Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Tan and I hope you're having a great day. Do you struggle with subtraction? Let's see if I can help you with that.
There are two ways we can think about subtraction. You're probably most familiar with the idea of subtraction as takeaway. For example, to work out 7 minus 2, you can imagine 7 cupcakes, and when you take away 2 of them, you're left with 5 cupcakes. We can also do this using a ruler. Start with 7 and count backwards by 2. 1, 2. We stopped at the number 5, and that's the answer. Let's do another one. Can you work out the answer to 12 minus 3? Start at 12 on the ruler and count backwards by 3. 1, 2, 3. We stopped at the number 9, and that's the answer. Now, counting backwards is easy when you're taking away small numbers, but it gets harder when you have to take away larger numbers. So another way you can do subtraction is to start with the second number and count forwards until you reach the first number. For example, to work out 8 minus 6, you can imagine 6 cupcakes and ask, how much more do I need to make 8? 7, 8. I need 2 more cupcakes to make 8. If you do this using a ruler, it's even easier because you can see the two numbers you're working with before you start counting. Start at 6. How much more do I need to make 8? 1, 2. We can see that the distance or the difference between 6 and 8 is 2. This is a very useful way to think about subtraction. Let's try another one. Can you work out the answer to 15 minus 8? Start at 8 on the ruler and ask, how much more do I need to make 15? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's right! The answer is 7. Good job! Let's write down the first number, one digit in each square. 68. Then we write the second number directly underneath, lining up the columns. 25. Then we draw a line and start with the ones column on the right hand side. 8 minus 5 is 3. Then we move to the tens column. 6 minus 2 is 4. And so the answer is 43. Now this subtraction looks very similar to the previous one, but if you look closely at the ones column, it doesn't say 8 minus 5 anymore. It says 5 minus 8. And that's not the same. Just imagine, if I start with 5 cupcakes, I don't have enough to take away 8. Oh dear, what are we going to do? Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to write a little 1 in front of the 5, and at the same time, I'm going to write a little 1 down low in the next column. When I write a little 1 in front of the 5, I'm adding 10 to make 15, so that I do have enough to take away 8. and when I write a little 1 in the next column, I'm keeping my calculation balanced by subtracting out what I put in, and I'll do this later when I move to the next column. It's really important to write both little 1s at the same time so that you don't forget. Right, now we can do the 1s column. 15 minus 8 is 7. Then we move to the 10s column. 6 minus 2 is 4. Take away 1 more makes 3. And so the answer is 37. Let's write down the first number, one digit in each square. 4,829. Now when we write the second number underneath, we have to be careful because it's only a three-digit number. We have to line up the hundreds, the tens, and the ones. And then we draw a line and start from the right-hand side. Let's start with the ones. 9 minus 2 is 7. Then we move to the tens column. 2 minus 3 we cannot do because we don't have enough to take away 3. So we write a little 1 up high and a little 1 down low in the next column. Now we can do the tens column. 12 minus 3 is 9. Then we move to the hundreds column. 8 minus 5 is 3. Take away 1 more, makes 2. Then we move to the thousands column. 4 take away nothing is 4. And so the answer is 4,297. When you're adding and subtracting decimals, the easiest way to make sure you line up the columns correctly is to line up the decimal points first and wrap your digits around them. So the first number, 20, is a whole number and goes just before the decimal point. And the second number is 5.47. And you'll need to pad out the first number with zeros so that we have digits in every column. Now I'm going to write down the decimal point first, before I forget. And then we start from the right hand side. This is called the hundredths column. 0 minus 7, we cannot do. So we write a little 1 up high and a little 1 down low in the next column. Now we can do the hundredths column. 10 minus 7 is 3. Then we move to the tenths column. 0 minus 4, we cannot do. So we write a little 1 up high and a little 1 down low in the next column. Now we can do the tenths column. 10 minus 4 is 6. Take away 1 more, makes 5. Then we move to the ones column. 0 minus 5, we cannot do. So we write a little 1 up high and a little 1 down low in the next column. Now we can do the ones column. 10 minus 5 is 5. Take away 1 more, makes 4. Then we move to the tens column. 2 take away nothing is 2. Take away 1 more, makes 1. And so the answer is 14.53.
So keep practicing, and thanks for watching.